If there is one common stereotype of NBA players, it's that they have to be tall to have success. There are a handful of short players that have great seasons and great careers, totaling big points and assist totals, and many of them playing over 10 years in the league, and that includes Muggsy Bogues. In this video, let's zoom in a little bit at his career and see how good Muggsy Bogues truthfully was. If you know the guy or you just heard of him now, then this video is a must-see. Tyrone Muggsy Bogues doesn't want to only be remembered as the Charlotte Hornets' all-time leader in assists and steals or for being the shortest player to ever make it to the NBA. Personally, his legacy and how he views his career is pretty straightforward. Topping out at just 5'3", Bogues played with the heart, tenacity, and ferociousness of a player twice his size. His 10 years with the organization were highlighted by plenty of on-the-court accomplishments, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. A native of late 70s, early 80s inner-city Baltimore, Bogues was raised in the Lafayette Court Projects by a single mother, Elaine. Much of the surrounding area was overrun with violence, drugs, and other gang-related activity. Safe to say, the odds of making it to the NBA were already stacked against Bogues from an early age. Bogues became a star on the legendary Dunbar High School team that included future NBAers, Reggie Lewis, Reggie Williams, and David Wingate. He landed a scholarship at Wake Forest after leading the Poets to a combined 60-0 record, his final two seasons, and a number one national ranking. After leaving Wake Forest and becoming the Atlantic Coast Conference career leader in assists and steals, he was drafted 12th overall by the Washington Bullets in 1987. In his rookie year, Bogues was a teammate of Manute Bol, who stood 7'7" tall. They were the tallest and shortest players in NBA history at the time, with 28 inches difference between them. Bol and Bogues appeared on 3 magazine covers together. Bogues blocked 39 shots as a professional player, including one by the 7-foot-tall Patrick Ewing on a game in April 1993. He reportedly had a high vertical leap, but his hands were too small to hold onto a ball to dunk one-handed. Bullets rivals, the Miami Heat and Charlotte Hornets, were set to enter the NBA for the 1988-89 NBA season, and despite Bullets' weakness at the point guard position, he was even left unprotected by the Bullets. In 1988, the Hornets selected him in the NBA expansion draft. As Bogues settled in Charlotte, he established himself as an exceptional passer, a great stealer, and one of the fastest players on the court. The team only won 20 games in its inaugural season, but watching the pesky speedster Bogues race up and down the court, dishing head-spinning passes and swiping steals certainly was a bright spot. Maybe it was because of his height or that trademark grin, but Bogues' popularity quickly began skyrocketing as his NBA career unfolded. He used his diminutive height to his advantage, whether it was by weaving around taller defenders, putting the basketball where it couldn't be stolen, or setting up teammates with only passes they could receive. Bogues was never going to be a player who dominated by scoring or rebounding, although he always found other means to control the game. Muggsy spent 10 years in Charlotte as the Hornets, led by Alonzo Mourning and Larry Johnson, became one of the NBA's most popular teams and a perennial playoff contender. Bogues was one of the most popular players in Hornets history. The NBA community considered Muggsy Bogues as a strong, quick, tenacious on-ball defender. He was a defensive nightmare and loved guarding players full court. His height was used as a weak point of other players to outplay him, but Michael Jordan also used it to be a jerk to him. The incident took place in Chicago. The series was tied at 2, and the Hornets had a chance to win Game 5. Down just by 1 to the Bulls, the Hornets needed to make one huge basket to avoid getting kicked out of the 1995 NBA playoffs. Muggsy Bogues took the ball during his biggest possession of the game, with Michael Jordan guarding him. Eventually, Jordan stepped back to give Bogues some space. It is said that Michael Jordan ruined Muggsy Bogues' career by calling him names and let him shoot it to win, yet he failed miserably. The Bulls won that game 85-84 and moved on to the semifinals. The rumor is that this comment and the following play ruined Muggsy's career. He was never the same. He averaged only 5.9 points per game for the rest of his career, and the community usually blames MJ for that. To put things in perspective, before MJ's comment, Bogues averaged double digits for 3 straight years. Eventually, he told Johnny Batch, the Hornets coach at the time, that he believed that exact play ruined his career. The Hornets parted ways with Bogues shortly after the start of the 1997-98 NBA campaign, trading him to Golden State. He totaled 4 more NBA seasons before playing his final game with the Toronto Raptors in January of 2001. After leaving the NBA, Bogues worked in the real estate business until August 2005, when he was named head coach of the Charlotte Sting in the Women's National Basketball Association despite a lack of coaching experience. He was shorter than all his players. Bogues led the Sting to a 14-30 record before the team folded in January 2007. In 2011, he became the head coach of the United Faith Christian Academy boys high school basketball team in Charlotte, North Carolina, after serving as an assistant to former head coach Sean Wiseman. His autobiography, In the Land of Giants, recounts the struggles of growing up in inner city Baltimore and achieving success in the NBA. On March 2014, Bogues was named the Charlotte Hornets ambassador, participating in the team's rebranding. In the year 2020, Muggsy is active with multiple charities, youth basketball camps, and other ventures to help better communities and teach children valuable lessons through basketball. He also will show up to Hornets games every once in a while. You might see him hanging out with his old buddy, Del Curry, or taking pictures with fans. Though he played for other teams, Bogues will always be remembered as a Charlotte Hornet. He played his best years in the Queen City and helped the team to their initial playoff successes. For a guy that small, he certainly made a huge mark on this city, and it's one that older fans won't forget. If anything, he showed that sometimes, heart beats height. Make sure to keep posted with our videos to keep yourselves updated with your favorite star's whereabouts. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe for more.